So can you share the short and long-term effects of what is PAE, prostatic artery embolization of the prostate?
So this is one more way to help men with big prostates that are having urinary problems. It's not used as a cancer treatment. It's used as a BPH treatment. And there are a number of them out there, you know, the urolifts and the resumes and the transurethral resections, laser vapor, on and on and on. The PAE approach in skillful hands is effective. I'm not truly an expert in all the different methods of shrinking prostates and treating men that have urinary problems. But basically, they take a tiny little straw, or they call them catheters, and they thread it up through the bloodstream right into the prostate, and then they inject substances that block the blood flow to the prostate. So the prostate becomes starved of blood and dies. And so it's one more way to shrink prostates, and I think it's a reasonable treatment, probably most attractive in people that have really, really big prostates, because sometimes super large prostates are difficult when you try and do the resumes and the urolifts and things like that. So like anything, I'm sure it's a skill procedure, and you want to find someone that's really made a career out of doing that one thing before any individual submits to going off and having this done.
So when it comes to starving the prostate of blood and the prostate tissue dying, is it going to affect sexual activity at all?
I think there's always that risk. All these treatments to make the prostate smaller can influence sexual activity in some cases. They don't always. In fact, it's quite possibly only a minority of men that have those problems, but there's always that risk.
And when we talk about BPH, we see larger prostates. Is it more effective with a certain size of prostate, like extremely large prostates, less large? You know, anything over 40 cc's is larger, but...
Yeah, I think that some of the other procedures are simpler, resume procedures, urolift procedures, than prostatic arterial embolization would be. So I would be thinking of it more for men with particularly enlarged prostates.
And as far as how many patients have you seen this done on, and have you seen long-term effects where it's really worked for them?
Yes, not a lot. A handful of patients have gone through this procedure that I know of. They were definitely improved. It's only been over the last couple of years that I've seen patients with this type of treatment, so I don't know how they're going to be in 5-10 years.
Hey everyone, it's me, Alex, and our mascot, Hunter. You can check out his Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow, at the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and in fact, if this dog high fives me, high five, high five. Can you high five me? Thank you. You have to subscribe. Go subscribe to the YouTube channel. He even thinks that's awesome. Also, don't forget to visit our website, PCRI.org.